So, lads, onto the Hibs women's team, and you two have been fantastic supports for the women's team this season. I think you've been to mostly every single game, which is good. Really enjoyed reporting on the women's stuff. So, if you're looking for Hibs women's content, this is the podcast for you. So, the Hibs women's team, they're currently sitting in fifth place in the league. They're 2 points behind Hearts, and Hearts have a game in hand. So, talk to me about the Hibs women's season and how it's been going so far from your point of view, guys. I know, Charlie, you're quite, you've followed it very close. This is your second year following it. So, let's hear what you've got to say, what you think.
Yeah, mate, obviously last year I couldn't really get to many games because I was living in Stirling, but now I'm back in Edinburgh. It makes it a lot easier because they're playing at Meadowbank, which is class. Great facility if you haven't been along to watch a game there. I really do enjoy the games at Meadowbank. It's an easy place to get to and tickets are cheap and that's class. I think it's been an up and down start to the season. Obviously, we lost 9-0 to Celtic first game, which, to be honest, I think a lot of people were looking too much into that. I think, you know, Celtic are class. We had half a squad. So, I think, you know, since then we've won a few, lost a few, drawn just the once, Jack,
yep, against Scotland. Against Spurs, that was the only one, aye.
So it's been an all right start. You know, obviously, my game of the season, although it was a defeat, was the one against Rangers. You know, we held Rangers to only a 1-0 from a wonder free kick from Middag. Cracking goal, but I thought we were comfortably the better team on the day. Probably should have won. Had a few chances right at the end, could have scored two or three of them, but and obviously into the semi-final of the League Cup, which is exciting. You know, they're playing Glasgow City away, which, to be honest, I'm not really expecting us to get any further. When I seen the draw, I was hoping for Spartans to get to the final, but yeah, you know, stranger things have happened. You know, we've got a good record in that cup, so hopefully we can get to the final. But I think it's been a good start to the season, mate. And obviously, you know, big game at Easter Road coming up in a few weeks' time against Hearts. So yeah, like, I've got a real interest in the women's team now. You know, obviously last year was pick or mix, but I'm going to try and get to at least every home game I can this year. And it's great entertainment as well. So I'm loving it so far.
And about yourself, Jack, well, you made at the start to the campaign, obviously quite different from last campaign, I would say.
Yeah, definitely.
So talk to us about the difference between the two campaigns, obviously last year and then this year, and tell me sort of why is this year seem to be a wee bit more less fluent than last year?
Obviously, last season we started the season spectacularly well. Obviously, started off with that 2-0 win against Spartans at Tony Macaroni, which was obviously our first league game in our new home through in Livingston. I think it was a good buzz about the squad then. Had that pre-season, had the League Cup group stage, quite a long pre-season, and I did the League Cup group stage there as well, which I think helped. You know, then we went and beat Motherwell, she's fine, thank you, 4-0 out at Alliance Park. Obviously, Motherwell's a team we've actually lost to this season, which I think is the first time ever we've lost to Motherwell.
First time ever.
So, you know, you're comparing that there. Then we very narrowly lost to Celtic at the Excelsior last season. Obviously, very different from when we played them away this season. And then we beat Hearts in front of that record crowd at Easter Road in that derby. So I think if you compare the starts to the season, they have been markedly different. I think the one thing that's hurt us this season, first of all, is the lack of pre-season. Obviously, the League Cup, with it going under the Sky Sports sponsorship, got rejigged a bit. So there was no group stage, which I thought was disappointing. The group stage lets you... The good thing about the group stage last season, from a fan's point of view, is A, you got to meet some of the new players, you got to see some of the new players and got to know them a bit better, and it was just more football as well. And then from a sort of squad point of view, the League Cup group stage, much as it is with the men's, a great sort of pre-season. It gets minutes in the legs, and it's also competitive football as well. It actually means something. It's not just like a typical friendly game, which doesn't really mean anything. So I think that really sort of hurt us, not having that League Cup group stage and not having that pre-season. Literally, you know, you had Nor, Crystal, two separates. They'd literally just come into the country and got their work permits through, and boom, there you go. You know, go and play Celtic, you know, the double cup champions from last season. So I think it was always going to go sort of a bit skew-whiff. Of course, we were brilliant against Hamilton, but looking at where Hamilton are now, I expected that. And obviously, we went and gave them a good seeing to in the cup as well. at New Douglas Park, beat them 8-0. And then it was, I think to me, if I'm singling out the most disappointing one, it's a loss to Motherwell. You know, those are sides that in the past we'd be easily tucking away. And I think it's the way we lost it as well. Bad refereeing performance, first of all. And I don't think you can blame it all on the referee, but the referee was shocking that day. And then it's the fact of, and Dean, I think it was very right what Dean said after the game, which is if we'd won that game 6-3, nobody could have complained. We didn't take our chances. Motherwell had three shots. One of them was a penalty. Motherwell had three clear-cut chances. They scored all of them. We didn't take our chances. And I think that's been the story of the season as well. The draw to Spartans, Ainslie Park's always a tough place to go for us. And I think the draw against Spartans was straight. We really should have won that. It all comes from a free kick that wasn't really a free kick. I think the one thing that's hurt us this season really is set pieces. You look at Spartans, we dropped 2 points because of set pieces there. And then Rangers, it all comes from a free kick as well. Although, to give Tez Almidag from Rangers credit where she's due, that was a wonder strike. I don't think no keeper was keeping that out. I mean, no even Zinsberger, the Austria keeper who was like voted the best of the Euros. I think even Katrin Zinsberger was keeping that out. There's no way. There was no way in Merle Frims or Katrin Zinsberger wasn't keeping that out. Never mind Benny Haaland. Although I think that's the thing as well for me is I think at times we've been a bit, I think it's the sort of lack of organisation and defence that's hurt us at times. I think Benny is an excellent shot stopper. She really is. Your Benny, distribution's excellent. Shot stopper, she does everything in that department better than Gabby. But you miss Gabby's communication. You know, Gabby was good at organising her defence and from set pieces especially, Gabby was good at commanding her box. You just don't get that with Benny. Benny doesn't really shout. And I think that's what's hurt us. Also, there's been a few where Benny's dropped the ball or she's went to go and punch it when she could have caught it. And that's led to obviously those situations where we've conceded from corners and free kicks when we really shouldn't have. And I think that all comes from the goalkeeper not organising our defence. At the same time, I think there's been a few where we maybe our decision making's leaving a lot to be desired. I think that's what's hurting us. I think if the defence, and we've seen that in the past couple of games, if the defence shows up a bit, it goes really, really well. I think Siobhan and Joel, that centre-back partnership's lasted the test of time, and it's still working. I think Joel, obviously, 35 years old, the legs aren't what they used to be, but I think Joel's actually been decent this season. She's made a few mistakes here and there, but I think she's been decent, and at 35, and with all the trophies she's won as Hibs captain, I think we can forgive her it as well. And Siobhan, I mean, Mrs. Hibs, made her 250th appearance against Kilmarnock at the weekend there. And just every time, you can tell what that means to her. Every time she's out on that pitch, you know, uncompromising at the back. I think Poppy and Liana are two new defenders, have looked really, really good. Shannon Leishman, I think every time Shannon Leishman's played, outstanding, which I think Charlie's got to eat some humble pie on that one after saying that she'd be the disappointment this season. I think Shannon Leishman's been one of our most consistent and best players. So I think all in all, we've actually been okay. If we can just find a bit more consistency with the results, I think we're there. We've got a really good squad. We've got a lot of great depth, which we didn't really have that last season. We were very unlucky with injuries at times last season. This season, we've got the depth. You know, you've got, in terms of forwards, you've got Knorr. Crystal has been outstanding. Crystal is twice the footballer Alexa was. You know, Alexa was good at hold-up play. Alexa was good at getting stuck in there, but she just was not clinical. Crystal knows where the back of the net is, and she's also got a bit of trickery about her. I think the problem with Alexa was it was difficult for her against defence. She was a big target, and she was easy to take out. Crystal makes it difficult. You know, she's quite short. She's got a bit of flair about her. I think Big Knorr, she's not afraid to get stuck. In fact, she's only one yellow card off a suspension now, I think. So Knorr's not afraid to get stuck in. The Big Knorr Brahimovic, she's not afraid to get stuck in there. I think she's been really, really good. She came on her game against Kilmarnock. Christina Freda, I've been really impressed with her as well. She's looking like she's the player she was when she was back in Cyprus, to be honest, with the goal-scoring form she's been in. Ailey, the girl keeps getting better. Every time I watch Ailey play, she gets better and better and better. Rosie Livingston, I think, very much on the same track. That, considering she's 16 years old and already firing the goals away, that girl's got a big future as well. So you've got, that's just the forwards I've mentioned there. You've got Lucy Parry as well, 18, on loan from Liverpool, a WSL side, absolutely ripping it up. I think Lucy Parry's been amazing and does her work defensively as well. You've into the midfield, Shannon McGregor. Why is she not in the Scotland squad? Shannon McGregor needs to be in that Scotland squad. She's been our most consistent player for me this season, Shannon McGregor. Regularly been the best player in just about every game I've watched. She's been amazing. Mickey as well. I think Mickey's a quality footballer, and I've said that plenty of times, but we are so lucky we got her for Spartans, because she could have easily ended up at a Celtic or a Rangers or even Hearts. So I think we are very, very lucky to have Mickey McAloney. Then moving into the sort of defence, we've got Poppy Lawson, a very good young player. I think Poppy, her confidence will grow the more chances she gets. You know, you've got Leah Eddy. Leah's, again, consistency, misses consistency. You've got Siobhan, Joelle, two long-term club servants who have been absolutely amazing still. I think the only position I'd say that the depth's maybe not that great is goalkeeper. You obviously, Hannah Marriott left to go to America, the under-19s keeper who was training with the first team out. From what I've seen when she was warming up and went training, and was a good keeper. So, sensible move for her to go to America. Unfortunately, Ellie Tebbit got injured, which I thought she was a good keeper. She was good for Kilmarnock and were a little spell with them. And unfortunately, she never got to prove herself at Hearts because she got injured. Again, she's picked up the sort of similar injury. I think looking at Daniela Kaczynska and Benny Haaland, I think Benny's, like I said, excellent shot stopper. She does what the problem with Benny is she'll pull off a wonder save and they make a really easy blunder about 2 seconds later. I think she's that sort of keeper. She'll make a save that requires superhuman reflexes, and you'd expect nobody but Lev Yashin to make that save. And then, like, literally 2 seconds later, she'll let the ball trickle under her, or she'll try and punch away a corner instead of catching it, and it ends up in the back of the net. And I think Daniela Kaczynska, I've just generally not seen enough of her. She got, I think, a half against Kilmarnock.
Kept the clean sheet.
She kept the clean sheet, though, which I've got to say, but I think she's literally just there for cover if Benny gets injured. The girl's quite young and she's already been at quite a few clubs. I mean, her CV is worse than some of my football manager saves, and that's saying something. So I think she's been at a lot of clubs, Kaczynska, but from what I heard and what I've seen, she was pretty well assured against Kilmarnock. Didn't have much to do, obviously, but I think we were winning 6 or 7-0 when she came on. So, you know, I think a goalkeeper's the only position for me, but apart from that, we've got so much strength. We've got a squad that are fighting for each other, playing for each other, and we just keep going from strength to strength. It's been a slow start, but, you know, in a semi-final, I fancy our chances against Glasgow City. You know, we've got a good record against them in the Cups, and the motivation's there. You know, it's a big showpiece event. The final's going to be on Sky Sports. It's at Tynecastle. It's an Edinburgh-based final. So to get there would be absolutely outstanding. And I think if we get there, Rangers were nothing special against us. And I've got to agree with Charlie. Despite the loss, that was our performance of the season against Rangers. You know, the spirit we showed in that game and the determination, it was amazing. And we should have at least got a point out of that. Of course, Rangers get the dodgy free kick, as they always do, because the Masons wouldn't be happy if Rangers lost. One Rangers team needed to win that weekend, so they needed to make sure of it. So, you know, all joking about that aside, I think we genuinely should have taken something from that game. I think Nord did a bit of a blowjang right at the end. She was right through on goal and sclaffed it. And I think that's, for me, in those big games, you need to have that cutting edge. We just didn't have that. But I think all in all, the women's season's been... it's picking up now, and I'm really impressed with the squad. And you're like Charlie says, you know, Meadowbank's a great facility for the home games, and I'm so proud to support this group. They're an amazing group with the fans. They're an amazing group for the club, and you know, we're just going from strength to strength now. So, folks, if you haven't come down to see Hibs Women yet, it's only £7 a ticket, or £8 now, I think. So get yourselves down to Meadowbank, and you're going to see some fantastic football and a group of players that really want to give it their all for the fans and for the shirt and for the club. And that's what it should be about at the end of the day. And I genuinely think we're going to push on from this. There's a lot of exciting things happening at Hibs Women. And I think it is going to be a good season. I can see us finishing sort of fourth again this season, which I'd be perfectly happy with, if I'm being honest.
And just to touch on what you were saying there, Jack, as well, obviously it's £7, £8 a ticket. Or you have the option to go to the hospitality, which me and you will be doing this week.
Is this your first game of the season?
Listen, I've been to plenty of Hibs Women's games in the past. Plenty of Hibs Women's games last season. Drove through at Livingston about 7 or 8 times to go watch them.
And Stirling.
And Stirling, I know. I've been to a fair few Hibs Women's games. But I someone sounding a bit bitter on the other end there, Jack, away, because we're going on a date.
I can't make it. The one week I can't make it, they offer us
someone
hospitality.
Hot heart, like
plastic.
Well, that's what you get for being plastic, Jack's right. So me and Jack will be there, and you can get your dinner and stuff like that. So it's got to be really, really good. And like you said, mate, as Charlie said as well, if you like football, if you're a fan of football, you'll enjoy the Hibs women's football team just as much as you will the men's. Good show and a great team. So, and it's also part of Hibs as well. It's part of the whole umbrella of Hibernian. So anything you can enjoy women's football because you're whatever. Trust me, get a go.
A dinosaur.
Denny Basher, unless you've tried it. So, no, we'll be there. And hopefully some other folk will be in attendance as well, which will be good. But not looking forward to it, guys. And I think that's been quite a podcast tonight. Loads to catch up on. So, but I call it a night there. You've got anything else you'd like to add?
I'll just go in there for the score predictions on Saturday then.
Go for it. I thought you were going to get a wee Twitter spat there.
No, not tonight. So obviously we're playing. Actually, we'll do both games. We're playing St Mirren Saturday. So Jack, come here first. St Mirren score prediction, please.
I think it's going to be 1-0 Hibs.
1-0 Hibs. Who's scoring?
Who's scoring? I think Big Mikkel is going. You know what? I've got a funny story about this, actually. When Mikkel first signed for Hibs, I've got a lot of Ukrainians were working. I actually asked Natasha, how do you say hello, you big sexy Ukrainian bastard in Ukrainian?
But anyway, I hope you're wearing that top, mate. You're going to get yourself locked up.
I promise it wasn't. My bail was paid, but I'm going to think Big Mikkel will score.
Well, if he scores, you can tell us how to say that next week in Ukrainian. They've had a decent start to the season, so they're above us in the league. I've got to say 1-1. I think
2-1 Hibs. I think
2-1 Hibs.
I didn't actually care who scores, to be fair.
Oh, I never thought who would score. Who'd ask who would score? 1-1, I'll say Boyle.
I didn't care. I'd take it to come off Portuguese's big toe twice, as long as we win. So,
what
women's...
What did Jeff Hanlon scored?
Celebrate like every other goal that goes in the net.
You're jumping on the Twitter bandwagon, aren't you?
Right, well, women's game. Yous are going, I'm not. I'm going to Glasgow for the evening. I would be. Hey, I'm going to Glasgow for the night, being plastic and all that. So I'll miss the game. But Calvin, come to you first for this one, mate. Hibs Partick Thistle. I don't know how they've started the season, Jack Wolf, but
they have been utterly rotten.
Right. Well, congratulations on your 3 points, Partick. Anyway, Calvin, yeah. What's the score going to be?
I think Hibs will win. I think Hibs will win 4-1.
4-1.
Aye.
Big score. Jack?
You know, against Partick, THISTLE, I think it's going to be... I'm going to say 2-0 because Partick were our bogey team last year. It's going to be 2-0 Hibs, I'd like to add. Just after saying Partick were a bogey team last season, it's no 2-0 Partick. 2-0 Hibs because I think they were a bit of our bogey team last season. Obviously, when we played them at Easter Road, they made it really difficult for us. I mean, that was not a pretty game of football. I mean, Ailey Adams to the rescue in that one. But I think it'll be 2-0. Partick are very sort of solid at the back, well organised. And I think they'll make it difficult. So I think 2-0. And I'm going to say Crystal is going to get a bag of celebrations in that game.
Right. I'm going to say, and hope that we carry on the scoring form we have had the past two cup rounds. One against a team for our league, 4-0 Hibs. I think Crystal will score twice, and I'd like to see Nor get a couple, so we'll go Nor twice as well. So aye, there we are. Hopefully,
so what
Hibs.
Are you going for?
4-0 Hibs, mate.
Oh, 4-0, right. Okay, I thought you were going for 4-1 and all.
No, 4-0, 4-0. Benny to have a clean sheet again.
I hope so.
There we go.
Right, well, that will conclude us. That will conclude the pod. Thanks for tuning in. Hopefully you've not missed us too much. And hopefully to be back as regulars again now, so we can just talk our nonsense on a Monday night yet again. There's a song coming out about that. Right, see you there.